So Saturday the 13th of June, and I'm joined today by the lovely the Ranzas, who are in Ayrshire in Scotland, I believe. Is that right?
Correct.
From Ayrshire?
Yes.
So you're the furthest band away from me, because I'm literally right down south, so we're like the opposite end of the country. But it's really good to have you on. We have Connor, Lyle, Murray and Julie. The whole band, is it?
Yep.
This is the first time I've had a whole band. So how are you all?
All right. I mean, given the circumstances, I think we're all missing the studio and actually being able to do some music. So as soon as we're able to, I think it'll be good for all of us.
I think so too. And for the fans as well. Get some new records out.
Yeah, definitely.
So a bit about your band there. I don't know who wants to do some talking, I don't know if you want to mix it up, but just like, when did you become a band?
And how can
you go, Connor? No, this is your one, Leo. You've got a story in the bag. You tell us one every day.
When did we form? It was, well, we used to be called The Shires. Previously, that was 2013. And then I think, it was about 2014, we changed it to The Ranzas, or Ranzas.
Ranzas?
We were trying to, I don't know what the idea behind it was, but I think Connor, you can explain why we dropped that.
Well, just trying to be a bit more modern, we dropped that. I think it was the Cortinos dropped the Cortinos, and then went just Cortinos. I was like, oh, that's the cool thing to do. We've still got time to change our name, so we'll change our name and modernise it.
Because you're still the Ranzas on Spotify, because obviously your Ranzas on Twitter, and I was listening to you earlier, and I was like, because I thought they were just Ranzas, and I looked at the spot, and I was like, oh no, they've got the.
I think it costs money.
Whatever. It's a cool name.
You can't change
it. Costs money to get.
It's just the name changed. So how did you become a band? Did you all go to school together? Or?
Well, Connor, my partner in. His partner at the time, were best friends and stuff like that, and we used to go on double dates, and that's where I met Connor. Murray, you joined in 2014, didn't you?
Right, my 21st birthday.
21st birthday, and Julie was a later addition membership.
A late entry, yeah.
Yeah. So Murray and Julie were in a wedding band together.
Yeah, that's how I met Murray, was just through a Facebook ad, and then Murray one day was like, hey, we need a drummer.
So you're the drummer, Julie?
Yes, I am.
Oh, a female drummer, so cool.
We all kind of know each other through friends of a friend anyway, so like, we always talk about how like we probably knew each other, so I was friends with Julie's friends from her old band Sigma. And then I knew Murray for college as well, so we all kind of like floated about, but we just never came together.
That's brilliant.
Yeah.
That's really good. And you've got loads of good tunes. I was listening to you earlier. I have listened to you before, but I was like, I was painting the fence earlier. I was like, right, I'm going to stick Ranzas on. But no, it's brilliant. And Sunshine as well. That's just perfect for today.
Thanks very much.
Oh.
I've just dropped my phone.
Ow!
You didn't need to tidy that room.
Yeah, you've got all this time in the world. You should be busy.
I've been busy today.
So have you been able to do anything much as a band since this whole thing started, or not really?
No, just the
quizzes.
Have you weekly seen quizzes. Are you going to become a little social bubble, or no?
Mm.
No. That's not in Scotland yet.
Oh, is it not? Oh, no. Of course, you've got different laws over there, haven't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yep, unfortunately.
Unfortunately,
so, I don't know.
So, Julie, what gigs were you supposed to be playing this year?
Special ones. Well, yeah, we bagged. Oh, that's terrible now. Put on the spot. What's the little festival that we got? Beautifest. Dearie me, that's terrible. They're going to hate me for that. But yeah, we were supposed to be going to Beautifest, and it was going to be really cool because you know you get to do the camping and. Lyle was going to be able to bring, you know, his dog in the way. So it was going to end up being a nice week and a weekend away for us all, in addition to playing a gig. So that's a particular gut. But we're on for next year, so
Good. So I'm going to talk to Murray now because Murray's been quiet. Hi, Murray.
Hello.
How are you doing? How are you doing down there? You're below me.
So,
what do you do in the band?
I'm the bassist and I roll cigarettes. That's fair.
Oh, dude. That's not about it. A bass is an important job. I love a bass in the band. It's always so cool. But everyone's so cool. So I'm guessing that... So, Lyle, you're the singer, yeah?
Yeah.
And yeah. Connor, you're the lead guitarist. Julie's on the drums. And Murray's on the bass. Yeah. And I'll be there. I can come along to your gigs and do maracas or tambourine or whatever. Because I try a bit with the guitar, but I'm so crap at it. So I had a little look. So you've played alongside quite a few bands.
Yeah, I've been about for a while, so I've played with lots of people. Kyle Faulkner was today. Done a gig with Kyle Faulkner on Trin just before the lockdown, as well as Sherlock's, the ABC.
In Glasgow.
I love it. And you've got such a good scene up in Scotland at the moment as well.
Yeah.
The music scene in Scotland is amazing. So many good bands.
Glasgow's crazy for the music. Like, there's just so much going on all the time. But we're not from Glasgow, so like kind of out the road. So sometimes maybe we get overlooked a wee bit from the Glasgow scene. But
we'll
still there, closest.
We'll change that. Like everyone, like I was checking, you knew Simon Donnelly?
Yeah, die. Mm-hmm.
Simon, yeah, Sid.
Yeah.
Footballer, he loves music. Well, I was chatting to him this morning and he said that he prepared all day for Liam Gallagher's listening party just to go and sit in his kitchen for 45 minutes by himself with his headphones in.
The things you do in lockdown,
it's a weird experience.
I know.
Yeah.
When this all kind of, when we're allowed back out and stuff like that, the gigs, that first gig's just got to be tremendous.
Yeah.
Wherever it is, it's just got to be quality, man.
Oh, because we had the garage sold out right when this started. It was like a week after lockdown was when we were supposed to be playing.
Sold out gig, ready to play.
Mm-hmm. Sold out.
Oh, what? So you didn't play?
We didn't get to play our gig.
Oh, I know.
Tickets are still valid for the next one, whenever that may be.
And are there still tickets available? Oh no, it's sold out. upgrade to a bigger venue.
Uh-huh. It's to a bigger, the next gig is a bigger venue. Its capacity is 350, I think.
Have you got a rescheduled date then or not yet?
It wasn't rescheduled, it was already in the plans, it was already booked. But we're using the one that was cancelled, you can still use the tickets for the next one.
And when is the next one?
14th of September.
Okay.
Edinburgh.
Sounds right.
The 11th of September, we're going to be playing Edinburgh for the first time. And then
19th of September.
19th was the Glasgow one. So that was maybe part of the tour, if that's still going ahead.
Brilliant. And fingers crossed by September.
Yeah.
That we'll have a bit of normality. I hope so. I'm missing gigs like crazy. Like this time last year, I was at Isle of Wight Festival. And I'm just like, and I was supposed to do Glastonbury as well this year, so it's all really sad. But we've got to be safe.
Yeah.
Let's be safe than sorry, hey.
Yeah.
So Julie, we had a little chat beforehand. So Julie is the first lovely lady to appear on a podcast with me, which I'm really delighted about. So I was just going to ask you, like, how it's been being a woman in a band, obviously full of males, and also the kind of industry or the kind of genre that you are is predominantly male bands, really. So just want to know how it feels to be a part of that as a woman.
Yeah, I think I have a slightly different experience, to be fair, with it, just because of the drumming aspect of it in the background most of the time anyway. But it's always brought up 9 times out of 10. Oh, it's really cool that you're a girl drummer. And it's like, yeah, I like to play drums. That's okay. But I get that not a lot of people see that. But I think that women singers or guitar players more in the front line of things probably have a different experience. I've never really experienced anything majorly bad through it. And the guys are all really sound, otherwise I wouldn't be in a band with them. But they've all kind of experienced it with me. The first few times it was like, wow, she gets like talking to a lot about the fact that she's a girl drummer. And now they all have the same expressions I do when people come up and be like, do you know the White Stripes? Do you know that the White Stripes have a female drummer? And I'm like, please don't compare me to the White Stripes drummer.
So that's but, the biggest thing. You shouldn't be compared, but it's. I just find it's always a real big thing because it is just. There's a lot of male bands out there, and I'm a real champion of female artists and female musicians, and I just think it's great. And fair play to you as well, because it can't be easy hanging around with three guys all the time. Speaking of my experience from having two brothers and loads of male friends.
Yeah, well, I've got four younger brothers, to be fair. So I'm kind of used to it. But like I said, you don't really pay attention. I call them out when they're, you know, being too boisterous, but I also egg them on. You know, Connor and Lyle fight a lot. That's quite entertaining, to be honest.
Why do you fight?
Oh, because they love each other. They love each other so much that they have to fight.
Just repress sexual tension.
That's what I was trying to say.
We can all relate to that right now. We can all relate to that. Someone said the other day that this year is going to go down in history for the first time that sex was ever made illegal for 10 days in England. I don't know if it's happened in Scotland, but basically the government said it was illegal to have sex with anyone, and then they cancelled that a couple of days ago. Like, you can. I'm like, well, thank God.
Thank you.
So anyway, it's been a crazy year. So about your band then, so did you have any like band influences, like bands that you like maybe looked at when you're writing music, or did it just all come naturally?
We've all got our different backgrounds and our different, like, I was total pop punk growing up and then just sort of spread out from there. And Connor and Lyle, a lot more indie, Arctic Monkeys-y stuff. But we've all kind of got a very spread out music taste, so we don't tend to think about other music when we're writing, I don't think.
So who does your writing then? Like, who writes the songs?
Usually me and Lyle.
Lyle.
Mm-hmm.
Good,
I'll be writing the lyrics, but then it's weird sometimes because you're in the studio and Murray will just come up with a bass line, and then we'll just be sitting there putting lyrics to it, and it just there's a song straight away. Or Connor, he can record in his flat, and he just sends over the recording, and I'll listen to it and just put down some lyrics to that.
I find it amazing, the whole songwriting process. Mm-hmm. Like, how if you just sat there, like, you think about like a waste and people like that, they're just sat there just playing about, and all of a sudden they just discover, like, an amazing riff or an amazing tune. Mm-hmm. I couldn't do that if my life depended on it. So I just find, I admire everyone that can write songs and work together as a band. It's great. So what's your favourite song then? What's your, like, biggest song? I know that Sunshine is your, like, but what's your own favourite?
I love Sinner. I'll never let us drop Sinner, because it is the best song we've got.
But our it needs re-recorded.
It does need re-recorded. Our favourite song, because I've got like an amazing guitar solo at the end of it, and I love playing it.
Favourite song's my favourite song.
Aww. I must admit, when I was listening to you earlier, you did a bit of an Arctic Monkeys vibe, and a bit Lush Shadow Puppets as well, when I was listening to you. I can't remember which song it was. I
wrote down
your song.
We do a cover of Crying Lightning. That's on SoundCloud. Or YouTube.
So do you all live separately? Do you all live in separate places? And
Yeah.
You and Connor used to live together.
A long time ago.
You used to be flatmates.
who used to be flatmates, Lau?
Connor and Murray.
What happened? Just fighting?
Yeah,
Connor and Lau fighting.
Just time was up.
Time was up.
Savage.
The tenancy ended, or just like, emotionally.
I got a girlfriend.
See, okay. That's funny. We're gonna play a little game in a minute as well. So we've been doing this with all the podcasts. It's not a hard game. Don't worry. So basically, what we do is I'll say a band and the number of Twitter followers they have. And it's a bit like a Price is Right. Do you remember that? You're probably too young for that, to be fair. So so I'll say a band and the number of followers that they have, and then I'll say the next band, and you will guess whether it's higher or lower.
Okay.
That's good.
Do you want to, are we ready to do it?
Yep.
Yeah, go for it.
Let me just find it. Right, I've got to find it.
I don't think you realise how competitive we are.
I know, last night was pretty intense.
Intense.
Yeah.
What did you do last night?
We do like a quiz.
Every Friday.
Who won?
Is it just you four?
Yeah,
and the manager, Alice.
And our manager, yeah. Alice. And I should, Lyle, I mean, you should mention that you team up with Shawnee.
I've got an advantage. But I've still not won.
Advantage. You did win.
Once.
Yeah, only
what
once.
Do you, what do you do your quizzes about? Is it like a general knowledge, or do you have like a subject that you do it on?
We do Ranzas, does Countdown. We do that, and they'll Photoshop my face onto Jimmy Carr.
Yeah. You can catch it on Instagram stories. We put up all of the questions on Instagram stories, so everybody can catch up and everybody can get involved.
So, we'll play, which band has the highest Twitter followers, higher or lower? So, I'm going to start with the Black Keys. Now, the Black Keys have 742,000 followers. Does Block Party, do you know Block Party? Do they have higher or lower followers?
I'd say higher.
I'd say higher.
They've been about longer.
Yeah.
Lower.
I'm not American.
Is it lower?
Yeah, because I'm not. We failed. First one, number one.
Is it?
Like, you're beginning to see Connor's like competitive side come out now. Like, it would just be head in the hands.
If someone asked me the same question, I wouldn't have a bloody clue. So Block Party have 120,400 followers.
Wow.
So okay. Higher or lower than Block Party, the Libertines?
Higher. Surely.
hold on. I'm saying lower. I should know this. I love them.
I know, you should. Both of you.
What's the final answer?
I'm going higher, but I'll go with the consensus.
I'm saying higher.
Higher.
Three highers.
Lower. We made these games difficult for a reason. So the Libertines have 82,600 followers. So it's not far off, but it's less than they should have.
That's just all the multiple accounts that Connor and Lyle have made throughout the years.
So, higher or lower than the Libertines, the Vaccines.
Lower.
It's hard, isn't it?
See, the Libertines were about before social media, and I would say the Vaccines were coming through.
Mm.
I'd say the Vaccines higher.
Yeah, go on then, I'll say higher.
I'm just going to back Lyle because he seems to get those bodies right.
Murray?
I got the first one wrong.
I'll say higher too.
Yeah, they're higher. So the Vaccines have 260,700 followers. This is quite a tricky one, actually. So higher or lower than the Vaccines, how many followers do Blossoms have?
I would say 200,000. I would say
260 the Vaccines have.
I'd say higher, because that cover they did recently, we got them quite a bit as well.
Paperback writers, I like that. That was class, man.
They did some class covers, haven't they? Really good.
I'm saying lower again.
Julia Connor.
I'll say lower.
I'm
back. Yeah.
You want to come
now? Well done.
Lower. So
I won all that.
121.4. Well, this is as of Sunday last week. Unless they've had a huge influx of followers by 140,000, then they have lower. and then finally, higher or lower than Blossoms, Manic Street Preachers. Big band back in the day.
Or
big by now, I suppose.
I do. Ah.
Could you see like what numbers going through Lyle's head?
It's right. Dude, to be fair, you could just be on your phone or on Twitter right now, going. Like, tend to look at the screen, like
30 seconds, hold on. 100
It's close, so I can say. It's very close.
Tempted to say lower.
I'm going to say higher.
I'll say lower.
Connor?
I'm back in Lyle again. Lyle's,
so it's 50-50.
Yeah, it's 50-50.
Okay, they're higher. But they have 135,000 followers. And that is the end of our little game of the podcast. So hopefully then, Ranzas, your next gig will be in September. With all being well.
Hopefully,
fingers
crossed. Yeah. Hopefully.
And what about any new releases? Have you got any new songs coming out?
We're working on a single just now. We recorded some of it before lockdown. So just trying to like piece some parts together. And hopefully we'll get that out ASAP. Mm. Apart from that, we're just going into the studio to record as soon as lockdown's done.
We're hoping the studio allows us to take back well, it's open a few weeks' time because they put a post up saying that they might be allowed to open. So fingers crossed it's soon.
But we are still socially distancing up here. It's quite strict. Mm-hmm. So.
And hopefully, I've seen all these things about the venues, like local music venues that are being affected by.
There was a fund going around, wasn't there, to save the Scottish music venues, and I think the ones down south as well.
Yeah, I think there's a Twitter page, Music Saves Venues or something, that are on a massive mission to try and raise money. But they just need to
be sad if that actually happens, if we do lose them. Any of them.
I just kind of see gigs happen socially distanced, and it's crazy, like, because such a...
Unless you're in a car.
Unless you're in a car.
Oh, they've done that in some places.
A car festival.
Yeah, seen that.
It's a good idea. Or Zorbs. They Zorb Zorbs.
That would be brilliant.
I'm genuinely, if someone put on a Zorb festival and you were only allowed out in your Zorb, I'd be totally up for that.
Crowd surfing would be a totally different thing.
Yeah, but you wouldn't have to pick anyone up, would you?
Yeah, exactly.
What you'd have to do is a Zorb would have to run up, go up to the stage and then jump.
Or just like build some ramps and stuff like that.
Yes! There we go. That's the idea for the future. In the next couple of months, the Zorb Festival.
I think you claim that idea just now before somebody else steals it.
Oh, it's here, it's here. It's down.
Right now, exactly. Ranzas, right? We came up with that. we put the festival on, you bastards. Right then, guys, I'll leave you to. I've taken enough of your lovely time on a Saturday night. So,
no, thanks for having us.
Thanks very much.
Enjoy your gin, Sam.
Yep. Get it, didn't you?
I love that. You did, Dan. I can't do a Scotch accent. It's really bad. Get the fork.
I was spotted.
I'm up here anytime.
So if anyone's watching this, then check out Ranzas. On Twitter, they are Ranzas Music, at Ranzas Music. So go and hit them up. They're amazing. They've got some quality tunes. And yeah, definitely good things. I can see it. Anyway, cheers, guys. Have a wonderful rest of your weekend. And thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Thanks for having us.
More than welcome.
Cheers.
Bye.
Cheerio.
Lights up.